Hello everyone, as in previous video we have seen the what is string, what are different operators which can be used in strings, then how strings can be formatted, and also we have started with some built-in functions over the strings. So in previous video we have seen some search functions, some comparison functions, etc. So today again we are going to continue with the same. So today's type of functions which can be used in strings are padding functions. So padding nothing but you just have to change your string by using some, you can say, extra characters. Now you may say, whether is it possible to make changes in the string? Yes, as yesterday I have already explained that strings are immutable. We cannot change them, but we can make some changes in the string in a fashion that we will be created a new string. We are not going to make changes in the original string. The only thing is new string will be created with the changed options. Now let's see how we are going to make changes, or what are exactly different functions which are available to make changes in a string. So the very first function is rjust. That means you have to justify your string to the right hand side. So where exactly these padding functions are used? Generally these padding functions are used when we want to insert some strings in a table. So you might have seen in your Word document also that we are having some justification options over the strings. So here also, when we are developing some software, some projects, and when data is being inserted by the user, so we need to format the data in a proper way so that it will fit properly in the table. So in such cases we may use these functions. So the very first function is rjust, that is right hand side justification. And what parameters you have to pass? You have to pass them the width and by which character you have to fill the remaining space. So just see the example over here. Here I have declared a variable, that is var, and having a string python. So what I am doing over here, I have just written var dot rjust by 10 pixels. It takes the pixels, not the spaces, nothing. So pixels are nothing but the smallest point or smallest dot in a generalized term on the screen. So it will move 10 pixels ahead to the right hand side. So when you are writing this, when you are displaying this variable, as you can see after the hash I have left some space and then I have written python over here. So this space can be considered. Now here we cannot give the approximate 10 pixels, but it will create some space over here. So likewise, when you are developing some software and you want your content should be written in a particular box to the right hand side. So in this box, when you want to write the particular word in this space to the rightest side, then you may leave your pixels or spaces over here. That is nothing but right justification, that those contents, that string will be written at the right hand side of that particular block. So likewise, you may also give any of the symbol which are to be replaced by that pixels, or you can write some or give some symbols which you need to put before that string. So see, if I'm going to write that you have to give the spaces or leave the spaces of 10 pixels and you have to replace that by this particular symbol, then the output will be in this sense, that is underscore will be, now it depends. Now see, here I had written 10 and I'm writing the symbol. So it is possible that in between these 10 pixels only 4 underscores may fit. That's why here 4 underscores will be displayed and after that your string will be displayed. So this is nothing but your rjust. Now same way, likewise we are having left justification, that is ljust. So here also you will have the same thing,
left justification, the width and the filling character we have to give. So I don't think we again need to elaborate what is left justification. Just only your string's contents will be at the total leftmost side, and after that you will be having some empty spaces. See here. Now here we cannot show that pixels after this string, but yes, after this some space will be left. And if you are displaying another string, it will be displayed after this space, after the 10 pixels. Same way, I can also replace that space by some underscore. So after the string will be at total the left hand side, and after that you have two, or that particular symbol will be replaced for the 10 pixels. Now, third part is center. That means neither to the left hand side nor neither to the right hand side. That means at the left and right position you may have that symbols, and your string will be displayed at the center. So that is nothing but center justification. So these are generally used functions where we need to format or store the data in the tabular form. So here, as you can see, same for the center function also, we have width and we have the character to be filled. So simply I have given the star and I have said that the width will be 10. So this will be replaced by these stars, the end positions, and your string will be exactly written at the center. So this is nothing but justification at the center. Now you are having Z fill. So as we have seen R fill, we have seen right fill, we have seen at the center. Now you are having Z fill. Z fill, and the parameter which we need to pass is nothing but width. So it is nothing but it returns string filled with an original content padded on the left with zeros, so that the total length of the string becomes equal to the input size. So what exactly you wanted to do? Suppose I have said, like when you are filling a form, when we are having some offline forms, you might have seen that there you are having some blocks to write your first name, last name, etc. So you might have observed that there few blocks remains empty. So many a times in computer systems also, when we are filling some forms, so it is possible that it is expected that you will be writing a data and few fields will remain empty. So in that case, Z fill is used. That means whatever string you have entered, suppose I have put the restrictions that user should enter a string having 20 alphabets, and by chance if you would have entered only 15 alphabets, so what about the remaining 5 characters or alphabets? So that 5 alphabets will be replaced by zeros. So here also, if I have given some length of the string, so to complete or to fulfill its length, I will be giving or I will be adding some zeros in that. So as you can see over here, I have written var dot zfill 10. So the length of the string should be 10. So Python original string is of length 6, and I have to add 4 more characters so that my total length of the string will become 10. So that's why I have added over here 4 zeros. Likewise, in the below example, in second example, you may see var plus Python. So whenever you are getting some special symbols in the string, so the zfill function will leave or will partition the original alphabetical characters and your symbol, and in between that it is going to insert the remaining required alphabets. Now see, the total length of here this string is 7. So we need to make it 10. We have to add the 3 zeros. So these 3 zeros are being added between this plus sign and the Python. So likewise, here you are having some of the padding functions where you can make the right justification of a string, left justification of a string, at the center, and Z fill. The next type of functions are
string substitution functions. The very first function is replace. That means you have to replace a particular part of the string by the new one. And you may write the count that how many times you want to replace it. Whether only once or twice, if you don't give that count, then by default it is going to replace all the strings which are in the given string by the new one. Let's check an example directly for this. So what replace is going to do? It is going to replace the old string with the new one. So as you can see over here, we are having an example. I have declared a string. This is a good example. And I have written a new string was. So what I wanted to do, I want to write instead of is, I want to replace that is with was. So how I'm going to call the function? Var dot replace. So here it's not the, okay, it is dot. So dot replace, and you have to give the old string which we want to replace with the new string. So here now new string I have already written in another variable named str. If I would have not saved that was in the variable str, I would have directly written over here as was. So this is also possible, and that in single quotes you may write the new string. So what output it is going to give me? See, here you can see the output. So instead of is, it has been written was. Now see what it has done. In this also there was a string is. So instead of this is also, was has been replaced. So this is how the replace function works. Now in second example, as I have said, how many times you have to replace that particular string. So here when I am writing var dot replace, I have to replace is with what? With was. How many times? One times. So now as you can see in the output, only the is which was present in this is replaced by was. And later the next is has been kept as it is. Now see, when you are executing this program, the original changes are not made in this var. If there would have been changes in the original var variable, then in second example it would have displayed was only. But as you can see in second example, there is only, which is in the original string. So as you can see, the changes are just made temporarily in the printing process, not the original string is being replaced. So this can also be one of the proof that our strings are immutable. Next, second function we are having, that is split. That means separating the original string. So you are having two parameters, sep and max split. That means if you are having a particular string, then how many maximum parts you have to make of that string. And suppose if you are not giving this limit, then it is going to partition your long string based on the spaces. Let's directly go to the example. Again, I have taken a variable. This is a good example. So now when I'm calling the function var dot split, it is going to split this whole string into parts depending on the spaces. That means this is one of the part, then is, then a, then good, and then example. So it is storing all this in the list. So likewise you will be having var dot split when you are giving nothing. That is the separator, no separator you are providing, and you are providing the three. That means it is going to make three parts of your original string. So this is nothing but you can say this, then is, and then a, and then good example. So it should be here four, not three. It is going to make the four parts of your string. So this is how you are going to get the result of the split. Then again you are having another example, that is split lines. As you can see, split the string at line breaks and returns the list after removing the line breaks. That means, as you know, you have seen the access specifier, slash n is nothing but for new line, slash t is for tab. So when you want to add the spaces, you use slash t. So such type of access specifiers are there in our Python programming. So when they are already included in the given string, see here, print new line, I have written slash n, the next line slash n, then move again to new line. So this is my original string. So when I want to make this particular access specifier, when I want to remove them and separate all the lines, at that time I use the function split lines. So here, as you can see, var dot split lines. So what it is going to do, it is going to remove this slash n from our original string and partition or separate out all the strings. So here, print new line, then next line, and then see here, there were two slash n. So one slash n will be removed and there will be just an empty space. It is not going to keep that slash n over here. It is just going to give you an empty space, and then again the next new line, that is move again to new line. So where it is exactly used, this split lines and this split, etc. So these functions are being used when you are having, when you are collecting a large number of data from some database. At that time you need to clear that data, you need to segregate that data, and you need to separate different lines of data. At that time we may use this type of functions. Another example is nothing but your join. Then again, if we can split a particular string, then definitely there should be some function available so that we can join the two strings. So you may say that we may have concatenation function directly where we can join the string, but in concatenation, as we have seen, we have to provide only two strings, right, between the concatenation operator, at the left hand side one and at the right hand side one. So we are just going to provide the two operands for joining the strings. Now here the join function allows us to pass any number of values, any number of strings, and we may join them not only directly but by using some special symbol also. Just as you can take a look over this example, see here, I have declared a string var in which I am having AB, BC and CD, and if I want to join these particular strings with the help of a symbol equal to, so I may join by using this simply str, that is this symbol dot join var. That means this particular string I have to give. So it is now going to give me the output AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. So likewise, I will be joining this particular strings with the help of an special symbol. So this is how we may have different options, or we are having a different options by which we can split the strings as well as we may join the strings. So this is all regarding the joining of the strings or substitution of the strings. Later part. Now we have reached to the last part of the built-in functions. So as we have seen some search functions, padding functions. So what was there in padding functions? That we were allowed to insert some spaces or some symbols in between the string, that is at both side of the strings, or at the left side of the string, or at the right hand side of the string. So same, the reverse functions are some available that we may remove the extra or unwanted symbols which are included in the string. So as you can see over here, we are having the functions L strip, R strip, then R index or length, etc. So what do we have in L strip and R strip? As you know, we have seen in the padded functions, we were having R just and L just, which were allowed to insert the spaces or some symbols in at both hands or both sides of the string. So reverse is the case in L strip and R strip. Here we may remove these symbols from the string. So for example, what does L strip do? L strip does that it removes the left hand side symbols of the given string. As you can see here in the example, I have declared a string star star python star star. So when I'm using the function L strip and I'm giving the symbol, that means which symbol I want to remove. So it will remove all the symbols which are all the star symbols which are there at left hand side of the string. So when I'm calling this function, I'm getting the output that it has removed all the star symbols from the left hand side. So as we can see in the next R strip will give us, it will remove the right hand side stars from the given string. So this is how we may use the L strip and R strip. As you can see, the definitions also here: return a string after removing the characters from the end of the string, and for L strip, from the beginning of the string. It returns a string after removing the characters from the beginning of the string. So here the characters, or here the what we can say, strings can be trimmed. Trimmed means we can make the larger strings into smaller strings by removing the unwanted symbols. So next we are having another type of function, that is R index. So what do you mean by R index? That means right hand side index. I think in previous built-in functions we have seen the function R find. So R find and R index are both same. Now the next function is R index. We have already seen such type of function, that is R find. So both R index and R find are same. What they are going to give? They are going to find a particular substring which we are giving to find from the given string, and it is going to return us the rightmost index. That means, suppose I had yesterday given an example. This is a good example. Suppose I want to find the substring is, and if in this particular example I am having is twice, that means it is in this also and it is here is also. So now it is going to return me the rightmost substrings index. So here is at the location 5, so it is going to return me 5. So this is the same, it functions same as the R find only. Now the another type of function is len string. So as you can see, len is nothing but short form of length. So it is going to give me the length of the string. So if I had given over here python, so it will give me 6 to be the length of this particular string. So many a times when we are doing large programs over the strings, we are using this length function regularly. So this is nothing but very important function in the strings. Then again we are having few more types of miscellaneous functions, that means some more functions we are having which we are using over the string. One is ends with. So it is going to return me true if the string ends with the specified value. So what do you mean by this? Suppose I want to check whether my given strings ends with a particular substring or particular character. At that time I can check whether my string ends with that or not. So if I'm giving over here, whether my given string ends with U, yes, it is ending with U, then it will give me the answer true. If it is not ending with U, then it is going to give me false. See, as you can see over here example, so I have given a particular variable text in which I have stored a string welcome to Python all of you. So now I'm checking the, I'm storing the function's return value in the result. Or directly, you also have an option, you can directly write this particular statement in the print function. So at that time also it is going to print directly true. So actually I forgot here to write here. Now I need to write here print result. So after that it is going to give me the output as true. So what value here it will be stored in result? Either true or false. If the given value u
and our string is ending with the same character, that is you only or substring, then it is going to return me true, else it is going to return me false. Now again, reverse of ends with is starts with. That means when I am giving a particular string, if I want to check whether my string starts with a particular substring or not, for example, here I am writing whether my given string, that is text dot starts with hello. If it is starting with hello, it is going to return me true. If it is not starting with hello, it is going to return me false. So this is what the difference ends with and starts with. Simply, these particular functions are used when I need to check the starting and end of the string. Then I am having two more functions, that is format and format map. So at the starting of the lecture only, we have already seen how format is being used to format a particular string. We are having a format symbol, that is what we can say, percent symbol, or even we are directly having a format function where curly braces are requested by the format function's value. So how we give the function, so how we are having the syntax in curly braces dot format the function name, that is, and the value, suppose variable name here I am writing var, so that var value is going to replace at these curly braces. So this is how we are using the format function. And then the last function is format map. So Python allows us to do programming over many maps, etc. also. So when we want to replace some particular points, its XY coordinate on the map, at that time generally we are using this format map function. So as you can see directly over here, example, I have declared a variable point where X coordinate is 4 and Y coordinate is -5. So when I am using this particular format, this star is nothing but it is mapping function. That means that this function is for map. So it is going to take directly, that means this point variable, and replace X with 4 and Y with 5. So this is the use of format map function.